we have looked at the work of artist Wayne Thiebaud, and what you've noticed is that he has done a lot of work of kind of like everyday type of food objects, and a lot of that, as discussed in the video, comes from his memories of working at like a soda fountain kind of thing. So anyways, there's multiple ways that you can print your donuts. We're going to be doing what's called a mono print, meaning it's just you're pulling, like, we're going to do multiples, but we're going to use like this cut, it's actually a pool noodle, and we're going to make like stamps of our donuts on some paper like this. However, I do want to point out that you can arrange the design however you want to, okay? So like you could focus on, maybe you want to have like three lines of three donuts in each line, so that would give you 9 donuts. Here I just did 5. This one, well, we'll come back to this one. This one I kind of did in like a circular, like almost like a radial design kind of thing. So if I like cut it in half, it would be the same all the way around. So I started in the center and then went to top and bottom, and then the side ones here. This one I really like because I went off the edge, and I'll show you how I did that so I didn't get it all over the table. But first things first, to start this, you will have each table, you'll have a tray of ink on the table ready to go. So I'll have that mixed and ready, and then if you need more, I'll give you more. But you'll take your cut pool noodle like this. Okay, now just notice too, these donuts are from the viewpoint, we're looking straight down on them. So like if you see here, like looking straight down at this, we have a perfect circle. Whereas if we looked at it from the side, it's more of an ellipse or an oval shape. So we're looking like a bird's eye view, like straight down. So I'm going to take my foam piece like this. Just kind of get it in the ink. Now you can see where the ink is not filled in on certain parts, so I might need to twist it and things like that. So I think this one I'm going to kind of keep it simple-ish and maybe go in a line. So I'm going to start right here, kind of press down, and notice it didn't totally fill in. So what I could do is I can twist it, or I can like turn it and print it. And I might even be able to get some ink off of this for the next one. Okay, it had some. I'm just going to get a little more. And again, I can twist. I'm going to go right here. What you might want to do too is you can like do ghost prints of this, meaning you're not getting fresh ink, and just kind of get the placement down and then go back and re-ink. Actually, the correct thing to do would be to go put it in the drying rack, okay? So if you want to print something like this one and you want to have the donuts hanging off the edge, what I'm going to recommend you do is you take a paper towel, okay, and you put it under your paper somewhat, ink your foam, and then I want this one right about here with just a little bit off the page. Look, it printed part of it on the paper towel, and then it printed the part that I wanted to print on the paper. So you've got these like cropped views, which I think is really interesting. We'll come back, and once it's dry, we will add color to our delicious looking donuts. So now that my printed donuts are dry, what I've got to do is I am going to add color to my donuts using oil pastels, one of my favorites. Think about like shadows and stuff too. So I'm going to think about where my light is coming from. So I'm going to start with this pink on this one. And you can
start with this light pink. And then I'm going to go in with a little bit of red and add that to the side where the shadow is going to be. So the light source is coming in from the left. So if the light's coming in from the left, that's gonna give me some shadows on the right. So I'm gonna increase the value, making it darker on one side and keeping one side slightly lighter. I even go in with a little bit of white and pop some white highlights into the frosting as well. I even come in with a little bit of yellow on the side where the light source would be and add that to the donut, like the cake part of the donut as well. Then I'm going to add my shadows. I start with kind of like a dark blue or dark purple. I avoid black until the very, very, very end, and you'll see that in this video. And then kind of like Wayne Thiebaud, I want to give these like nice bluish purple cast shadows. And wherever it's sitting on the table will always be darker. So it's going to be a little darker right at the very edge of the donut where it would be like sitting on the table.